Hello, everyone, and welcome to a daily dose of spiritual vitamin with Bonnie B. Today, on this episode, I decided I wanted to do something a little lighthearted. So the first thing we're going to do is have some music, because the last few contents have been kind of heavy. So we're going to have a little music, some prayer, and then we're going to do something fun today, lighthearted, okay? Going to learn how to figure out life path numbers and something fun, okay? So right now, the music for the purpose of the meditation of this segment of Spiritual Dose of Bonnie B is from Bob Marley. It's called Three Little Birds. This is a 12-inch mixed dub version. The sound was administered by the UMG and is licensed to YouTube by the UMG. It was published June 27th of 2009. We're listening to it now from the Macho Flame channel of YouTube. And it's called, from the CD called Legend, this is called Three Little Birds. About a thing, because everything gonna be all right. That's our message. Okay. Welcome, all of my star seeds, my light workers. Welcome, my divine masculines and divine feminines. Welcome, all of my newly awakened spirits. Welcome all those who want to change traditionalism in their lives and seek the face of God in its full truth and honesty without the rest. You are welcome. Welcome curiosity. You're welcome too. Everybody's welcome here. This is a channel for the spiritual warrior. This is a channel for the elect, the elite, the righteous. This is a channel for the child of God who's in the spiritual war, who needs to be prepared for his day of return. This is the All Calls Bulletin. This channel is not for everyone. This is for the awakened. This is for those who are serious about who God is and what we got on the table to fight. This is not a channel that's going to succumb to any negative how you feels. This is about God. This is not about Miss Bonnie. This is not about anybody in particular, but all of us individually. This is about our fight against the dark forces, getting ready for the spiritual battle that God has on the table. This is the Armor Up channel. Okay? That's what this is. So we're going to learn some fun stuff today. And so in preparation of learning the fun things that God wants us to learn today, because he said that we've been kind of heavy with these lessons here. They've been kind of heavy. Heavy, heavy. So he needed to lighten it up a little bit, give you a little music. We're going to do something fun today. But before we begin our fun adventure today, I'm going to pray. So if you'll join me in prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We thank you because we know that every little thing is going to be all right. We thank you, Father God, for a new day, the present that you've given us this day. We thank you, Father God, for how you're numbering to the soul family, for the righteous and the elect. We thank you, Father God, for the star seed who are waking up. We thank you, Father God, because we ask that as your word goes forth, that it not go out and come back void. We thank you, Father, for the increase in the harvest. We thank you, Father, for all the blessings, the trees, the air, for everything in which you have blessed us to receive. Father God, we thank you for knowledge, because knowledge is power, and power is freedom in you. Father God, we ask that the Holy Ghost guides us and takes us through this journey as you lead us. We ask that, I ask that you put a special hedge of protection around all those among the sound of my voice, Father God. I ask that you protect them, that you bless us all with abundance as we move into what is you, Source, our Creator. As we learn more about you, as we learn to love you, as we learn to hide your word in our heart, we ask that you guide us on this journey. Lord, we ask that the blood of Jesus be upon this broadcast and upon all those who can hear it. In your name I pray, dear Jesus. Amen. All right. Now, the fun thing we're going to do today. Ooh, that was kind of crazy, wasn't it? What are we going to do today? I'm going to learn some stuff. There are a few things I would love us to. Got some good stuff for us. Alright. For the purpose of this broadcast, because I want you to have some fun with this. But everybody's going to be different. Today, I'm going to teach you how to figure out our destiny. Let's do some life path numbers, calculations. Okay? Find out what your life path is. Because in order for you to stand in the position that God needs you to stand in, you at least need to know what your life path is supposed to be. How you know you're doing the right thing or not? How do you know in discovering who you are whether you're doing what's best for you? That's what a life path number is. It lets you know whether or not you're in the right alignment for your manifestations and for your forming of your life. So we need to figure out how to figure out these life path numbers. In order to figure out the destiny number, we use your name. Your name means something. Yeah. So, let's do life paths first. In calculating the life path number, first thing you do is you convert the day of the month, mine is March, which is a 3, and the year, say the year is 81, 81 would be a 9. You convert the day of the month in the year down to a single digit. So, you take the day of the month, which say it's a 3. And the year, say it's 1960. 1960 is 1 plus 9, which is 10, plus 6, which is 16. 1 plus 6 is 7. So, 9 plus 7 is 16. So you add 1 plus 6 and you get 7. However, 11 is a master number and should not be reduced. The same thing with 22. They have special meanings. So you add the remaining numbers and again reduce down to a single digit. So that's what we did. We added the month, which was March 3. We added the day, say the 1st. So March the 1st is 3 plus 1, which is 4, plus the year, let's say 1960. So 4 plus 1 plus 9 is 10, plus 6, 16. 1 plus 6 is 7, right? So you got 7 for the year, you got 4 for the day, 7 plus 4 is 11. You do not reduce that. That's the path. However, had it been 3, 7 plus 3, like the month was 2 and the day was 1, 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 plus the year, which is 7, 3 plus 7 is 10. 10 reduced down is 1 plus 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. So you're the life path 1. See? What I'm going to do now that I've given you how to figure them out, and you all have some fun figuring out your life path, let me tell you what they mean. Okay? I'm going to read to you what they mean. That's the simple formula for figuring out the life path. One, if you have the life path, one. This is a spiritual and primal number. It is a number that is a root of all numbers, and they all stem from this. Ones tend to be doers. If you are a one, you are aggressive and energetic. You look to produce results. You will not be limited to anyone or anything. You don't do limits. Life path one, you ain't doing no limits. You incite a urge to be a protector. And your dedication and passion to achieving your dedication. You're a natural born leader. Ones are leaders. If the letters in your birth total out to one, from adding the digits together, day, month, year, add the day plus the month, that'll give you a digit. Add the total number in the 4 digits of the year, that'll give you another number. Gonna add those two together. You're gonna get one number. Your number's gonna be 1 through 9 or 11 and 22. Okay? Just to give you some guidelines. But if you are a life path 1, you're a natural born leader. And you show why this number is related to the fatherly role. Even the shape of the one is strong, erect. And it reflects its meaning. The one is spearhead, always at the lead, and often forceful. Life path one. It stands upright, unwavering, and it's pride, and it has purpose. You are courageous and willing to try new things if you see promise, even if it's at a great danger. Ones are very individualistic, which can lead to loneliness. Life path one. Your primal urge to be a leader often makes you resent those with more power. And your inflated view of self makes you less likely to heed advice. Life path one. Ones generally have issues with trust. You believe if you want something done right, you must do it yourself. Ones feel entitled. You feel entitled to respect, and you can become demanding and domineering. When it's not given, that's when you get that way. Ones. When this happens, ones turn into warriors. And y'all don't get your respect. Y'all become warriors. You become the beast. That's a shame y'all gotta go there, ain't it? And will attempt to force your values and opinions. That's where you're wrong. But you will try to force your values and opinions onto others. And you won't listen to anybody else. Those are you ones, you leaders. You are a pragmatist and can have a hard time relating to others' emotions. So you usually repress people. Most of y'all probably Syrians too. Ones. Most of y'all Syrians. Bet you. Syrians, blue aliens. Ones, leaders. You will see through charm easily, and you will not stand for hypocrisy. So you've got morals, principles, and beliefs. This is your atonement. Your attunement. You need to harness your natural instinct to protect into compassion and understanding. That's what you need to do. You have great traits. These are all good things. But you need to harness your natural instinct to protect. You need to flip it around into compassion and understanding. Okay. It's wonderful being a leader, and it has its place. Definitely has its place. But one of the things my leaders need to learn is that in being a leader, you must formulate in this battle compassion. Because of the battle that we're in. And those leaders who inhibit starseed bodies, or whose starseeds are inhibiting the bodies of leaders that fall under different starseeds, divine masculines and feminines, who run on the life path once, who are very driven, who are leaders. And we commend you. The Holy Ghost is very proud. That's what he wants. However, in learning unconditional love, you need to harness the power of understanding and compassion. Okay. Twos. Life paths twos. Your numbers total out to two. You're the mother type. Ones are the father types. Twos are the mother types. The number two is thought to be a feminine number, with its power and strength consisting underestimated. Twos tend to be artists of sorts, always gentle and understanding, and diplomatic. If you are a two, you are a natural born peacekeeper. Life path twos, you're peacekeepers. Your innate urge to diffuse the situation rather than fight. However, twos are often underestimated. Twos are the ultimate survivors. You are extremely resilient and often the backbone of the family, mamas. The shape of the two is thought to resemble a person with their head down. See that? Two. Like a swan. Two. The shape resembles a person with their head bowed on their knees. See the knees? Head bowed. Praying. It's a natural sign of servitude. This position also represents strength. While ones represent power and pride, unwilling to bend at any price, they will break and shatter. That's the ones. But the two can bounce with it. Bounce back. It's the two. Bounce back fat. Bounce back. It's the two, but you can bounce it back. Bounce it. You know what I'm saying? Shit get hard. Get a little heavy sometime. Bounce back. Twos. They're willing to bend at any. Ones represent power and pride, unwilling to bend at any price. They will break and shatter with enough pressure when it's applied. And break. But in contrast, twos are able to bounce back. Like I said, they are able to bend in order to carry the crushing weight. This flexibility is what allows them to bend back and bounce back. And the weight, once the weight has been removed. So they might be bouncing for a minute, but when they bounce, when that weight is gone, they're going to bounce it back. Twos are often real, are the real power. And on the thrones, okay? It's some twos and backups. And they control outcomes and events through gentle forces. And persuasions without even being noticed. Okay. You are incredibly devoted, twos. And you expect the same devotion in return. However, beware when twos are betrayed or mistreated. The tactful manipulation is a verbal disaster. You're possessive and easily made jealous. If two feels under attack or they are crossed, They will unleash a side of vengefulness that is very cruel and unrelenting. Some twos. You will do whatever necessary to destroy your opponent. And you will not feel any regret or remorse when the battle is done. That's the problem with crossing the two. Okay? Well, that's all I got enough time for is numbers one and two, the mother and the father of life path numbers. So we're going to pick this back up. Play a little more music. Learn the rest of the life path numbers, okay? You all stay blessed. If you like the information on this video, give it a thumbs up. Check subscribe. Come on back for the next Daily Dose of Spiritual Vitamin. We'll find it.